Stop, how about the ball?
When the ambulance arrives, usually we saw
it. They don't
know
why we didn't go?
Because
she's tired.
Station 31, turn out for 315, 408, Sembawang Drive. Case of medical force, back injury.
Okay, so you need to. This one I always show you. Alright, you go under the boots, slowly under the boot. Then you make a figure 8, you tie. Okay, go in front, and tie by the side. Tie by the side. Okay. This is the first thing you need to do, tie by the side. Okay, you can tie whatever knot you look like, but best is a whip knot. Tighten it up. Okay. That's number one. Okay, huh? Now number two is to tie. Now remember, the fracture part is here.
Here, lower leg
fracture. Huh? So number two is to tie above the kneecap, slightly above the kneecap. So go below slightly. Okay, there's a gap, alright? Don't ever ask casualty to rest. It's very painful. There's a gap on there. You stick to push whatever bandages. Okay. Alright, point this side. Okay. That's the reason why I asked him to tie that side, huh? Okay. Okay, that's number two. The number three is to tie below the kneecap. Now this one you did all narrow bandages. Okay, or medium size also can. Okay, below the kneecap. Yeah. The last one, of course, is to tie below the fracture part. Right? Below the fracture part. Yeah? Okay. This fracture side. But in real emergency, you cannot follow the sequence. Just tie. Okay. So take something, use folded towel or clothing, and put in between as a form of cushion. Alright, this one you need technique to carry, but I don't show you lah. Alright, because if I go to teach at one, it take about 1 or 2 hours. just to how to immobilize. You know why the notes on the opposite side? What's the reason? Because when he conveyed to hospital, straight away the nurse would know which part of the limb is fractured. But looking at the knot itself, alright, a trained person, right? Now the knot is on the left, so the fracture eventually goes to the right. If the knot go to the left, the opposite, something like that, okay? So the situation, the place of the knot is very important. This one, alright, if casualty happened to be near danger area, smoke, fire, flood, you need to evacuate immediately. Both of you must be in a very safe position. Right? Don't let the flood die. Okay? Painful, painful. The limb can repair, but you want to save people's life. Clear? You can? Okay. And so you don't need to do what? You want to do? No. It just happened. Once you drop, hard time for you to roll it back. You have to take another one. Once you open, the bandage must go quickly to the hip or to any part of the limb. You cannot open and start talking. And then after that, you cannot. Because the more you delay, infection inside here. Because here, sterilized, here, free from germs. Right? So once you open, should be good. Just pray hard, the casualty head is flat. Alright? The casualty head is round, hard time for you to apply bandage. This case is not round, not flat.
Oh,
so, challenges for rescuer. Now, approach for the prankster, I'm here to help you. But don't worry, I already activate the ambulance. Go to the back. Apply this one. Right? Now, in size 15, it goes 2 round the chin, 2 round the forehead. In size 13, it goes 2 round the chin, 1 round the head. Okay? Yeah. So, don't choke casualty.
The mummy. Laki pala sa mga baba doon.
Oo.
When you reach here, second round, the long shot here, just twist.
Oh, twist.
Okay. And cover the forehead twice. This is the most difficult bandage to do. But the other are very easy. Well, you know, so this one you know how to do the bandage already. So the short tail is to end up the dressing. End up dressing here. By the side here. Use a ribbon knot. And tuck it inside here. Okay, white cross is maintain this one from falling forward. Right? Now you need a secondary dressing. This is a secondary dressing to immobilize which part. Okay. Now the base here, the base is the base. You fall about 4 cm. There you go. The forehead here. Okay, go in the back. Then you tie at the forehead. This is called dressing tomb of the skull. Tie a ribbon knot or shoelace knot. Then tuck inside nicely. Stand up this. See at the back? At the back. It's loosened. So hold the forehead here. This one, pull. Tighten up. This one, pull it. You have pin, you pin, you do the pin. You keep this side. Do that. This dressing of dome the skull. So I want you to do, not this one, but the secondary dressing. Okay? Okay, carry on.
Okay na to?
No better. Don't cover the eyes. Tie on the forehead, not tie on the hair.
So then,
forehead. Okay.
So this part later you share the adjustments. So right here, you twist. Then same
thing. This one you also but I did it over here. Over here.
Of course. Training wise, just make sure when you take your adjustment and stick up and look like right. So then you just make it tidy.
Tingin. 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 Tingin